So we've talked a bit about what our tool needs to be able to do. What tools are out there for us to use? Most people who make prototypes for a living work with a lot of tools, and many of them are very well tailored for a particular kind of prototype. Some of the tools people use are Keynote, PowerPoint, interactive PDFs, Balsamic, Pixate, InVision, and our good old pen and paper. Don't worry about trying to remember all of these. The point is to give you a sense of what's out there. In the next video, we'll talk about what tool we'll be using for this lesson and why. Each of these tools has various strengths and weaknesses, and each of them will become a part of a mature prototyper's toolkit. Let's get a sense of how each tool matches up with our requirements right now. Keynote is a common tool for when you want to present a low-fidelity prototype to a group, often within your company. It's very fast to work with, but it's hard to get remote feedback with and is non-interactive. PowerPoint is a very similar tool, and it's used for the same reasons. Again, speed is a strength here, but there is no built-in feedback and it's not interactive. Interactive PDFs made with Adobe InDesign are a common choice for designers who are workshopping user experiences. They are interactive, and once you've put in the work to learn the software, can be made relatively quickly. However, they have no remote feedback options. Balsamic, with a Q, is one of the faster prototyping tools, which allows for easy iteration, but doesn't have built-in remote feedback tools. Some people combine Balsamic with a user testing framework to handle that portion. Pixate is a prototyping software targeted at high-fidelity prototyping. It does interactions, and a lot of its power is in the way it deals with micro-interactions and animations. We'll revisit Pixate in the next lesson. For now, it's a bit slow for our purposes. InVision allows you to create interactive prototypes quickly and has a couple of dedicated tools for getting remote feedback quickly and effectively. And finally, our old friend, the pen and paper, is super fast, but doesn't allow remote feedback and it doesn't allow interactivity.